In today's video, we are going to understand how the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, narrowed down on the mistakes which it made with Chandrayaan 2 and then gracefully recovered from failure to eventually make India the first country in the world to land a spacecraft close to the South Pole of the Moon. ISRO's story is that of hard work and determination. Chandrayaan 3 mission objectives were clear. First was to make a soft descent on the lunar surface with the lander module Vikram. Second was to hover out the roving vehicle Pragyan. And third was to perform a range of in-situ scientific experiments on the south pole of the moon to make new discoveries. Before getting into the details of what went wrong and how it was all fixed, let me quickly take you through the launch process of any such space program. The spacecraft, which includes the lander module along with the lunar rover, is fixed on top of a huge rocket. This rocket is fired from the Earth's surface with rocket propellant fuel to create a thrust force, providing the rocket with energy to drive it up against the force of gravity. The spacecraft is designed in segments which get separated at various stages throughout the journey. After the launch, once the spacecraft gains enough momentum, the primary propulsion system is the first to separate. Next, with directional momentum gained from the rocket launch, together with the Earth's pull of gravity, the spacecraft projectile moves into the Earth's orbit and continues to go around in circles, gradually escaping away from the center of the Earth. During the journey, there come several stages of separation, and each subsequent separation assembly has its own secondary propellant system which continues to drive the spacecraft forward. As the spacecraft encircles around the orbit and slowly pulls away from the center of the Earth, there comes a point when it gets an indication to fire its engines and push itself into the lunar transfer trajectory. From there on, the spacecraft projectile catches with the moon's gravity and enters the lunar orbit and begins to encircle the moon, slowly getting towards the center. Chandrayaan 2 was able to achieve all these maneuvers successfully. In fact, as of September 2023, the Chandrayaan 2 spacecraft with high-tech instruments on board is still continuing to orbit around the moon at an altitude of around 100 kilometers from the lunar surface. It is recording observations and sending valuable information back on Earth. What failed on Chandrayaan 2 was just the lander module. The lander disengaged from orbital as planned and then began its descent towards the moon's surface. However, the controllers at the ISRO center lost contact with this lander when it was around 300 meters above the moon's surface. Later, it was confirmed that the lander module Vikram had crashed, ending the Chandrayaan 2 mission in disappointment. But ISRO did not give up. The team started looking back into its data in effort to figure out the mistakes which caused their lander to crash. Then, based on reconstruction of sensor data along with a detailed scientific hypothesis of the situation, ISRO eventually identified the reasons which caused the Chandrayaan mission to fail. There were four engines on the lander module which helped to maneuver the lander down through the descent phase. It is important to remember that there is no atmosphere on the moon. So anything coming down towards the lunar surface cannot just be controlled with air resistance through a parachute, for example. So the four engines on the lander module become critical in firing a thrust force to resist pull from gravity and slow down the lander's descent. These engines are also required to change the direction of the lander module. For example, to give it a turn, two engines on one side are fired with greater intensity than the two on the other side, thereby forcing a change in direction. So what happened was that after a landing location was identified close to the South Pole on the moon, the lander was directed to make a controlled descent with help from the lander thrust engines. At one point, the thrust from the engines became unexpectedly high due to an abnormal implementation of the thrust control logic, causing the lander to disorient as it came close to the moon's surface. In this situation, an automatic corrective action should have followed immediately. However, the core problem went unnoticed until a later stage. The control system eventually realized the problem and tried to readjust accordingly. However, there was an erroneous artificial limit set through an algorithm on the lander, which did not permit the reorientation or recovery adjustment for more than 10 degrees per second. This meant that the lander came down at a flawed velocity, and the automatic control system on the lander could not understand as to why it is not being allowed to turn sharp enough to be able to reach to its designated landing spot. The result was that the lander crashed 480 meters away from its actual landing position. Now, as mentioned before, that while the Chandrayaan 2 lander crashed, its orbital remained safe at an altitude of 100 kilometers away from the moon and is still working properly. So ISRO decided that with Chandrayaan 3, it's going to direct all focus on improving the lander module. They cut down on orbital related payload, which is now unnecessary, and instead utilized the weight capacity to strengthen the legs on the lander, to include additional propellant for the lander, to add some new information sensors on the lander, and to increase the number of solar panels and power batteries on board the lander. In finding the root cause of the problem, ISRO also figured out as to why the lander module's thrust system malfunctioned in the first place. The issue was in a valve control, so the slewing rate of this valve control was adjusted accordingly. Also, an instantaneous regulation scheme was applied for the entire power descent phase. This was to ensure immediate identification and timely correction of any error throughout the descent process, rather than letting the problem to grow and magnify until a later interval stage. Moreover, to account for any repeat case of disorientation, the previously erroneous adjustment control capability limit of 10 degrees per second was increased to be at 25 degrees per second now. This was to enable for greater maneuverability in case of a critical response situation. And if the lander module, while arriving close to the lunar surface, is still seen to be far away from its designated landing position with little chance of making it to the original landing spot, then the new salvage guiding system on board would come into play to reorganize the lander's control system and facilitate the lander in making a soft landing in the same off-target position. ISRO also developed and included an indigenous laser Doppler velocimeter. Didn't have this one on board on the Chandrayaan 2 lander last time. For some reason, ISRO was not able to procure it from the market, so they built one on their own this time around with aim to ensure better descent velocity tracking of their lander module. ISRO also made some improvements to the lander's operating software, mainly through new measures of data received from the Chandrayaan 2 orbital and also through some probabilistic estimations that were reviewed carefully in dynamic simulation models. For example, the Chandrayaan 2 mission presented with a close-up image of the moon's surface. This image helped ISRO to improve their understanding about a specific landing area, and so Chandrayaan 3 took this image on board and utilized a software to enable live feature matching of the lunar surface to get Vikram to align well and safely descend at the best possible location. ISRO's response after the crash of Chandrayaan 2 on the 6th of September 2019 was both resolute and innovative. And on the 23rd August 2023, ISRO eventually created a story of resilience and determination. Vikram from Chandrayaan 3 landed safely on the South Pole and Pragyan rolled out in pride. Together, Vikram, the embodiment of courage, and Pragyan, the seeker of knowledge, stand out as symbols of what can be achieved when we dare to dream and persist in the face of adversity. Today, as we look at the moon, let us remember the journey of Chandrayaan, a journey of valor and wisdom, a journey of setbacks and comebacks. It teaches us that failure is not an end but a beginning, and the path to the stars is illuminated by the light of human ingenuity and the unwavering resolve to explore the unknown.